we are discussing about the examination stress. As you are aware of stress, everybody is talking about the stress, everybody listening about the stress, everybody perceiving and feeling the stress. So what is stress? What is the definition of the stress? Stress is a body's response to a unpleasant stimulation or unpleasant condition. Anything can be called stress as long as it perceived as an unpleasant condition or unpleasant situation. Stress comes in many ways. It is an unavoidable consequences of life. It is a routine in our routine life or daily, day-to-day activities of every individual. A mild degree of stress, a mild degree of anxiety leads to the motivation and stimulating of the person. This is called eustress. It is a desirable and useful to everybody. Whereas a higher level of stress, a higher level of anxiety is called distress. It is going to harm your life and career, etc. So, appearing examinations, attending any interviews, these are the stressful events or stressful life situation in the younger or adolescent age group, children or male and female. So right approach, right coping strategies can decrease the or overcome anxiety stress of any individual on earth. So what are the causes for examination stress? There are so many reasons to get or getting stress of an individual. First is parental over expectations. Many patients over expect about their children, about their performance of their children, whether they want to get medicine or engineering IIT. Even student stress. Many students pressure for getting good marks, or even many colleges, many educational institutions are causing stress. They want rank, they want name by their students' ranks, and over competition or comparing with other students or marks, it is a become a social status of a family or a student. Are so many other causes. For example, health of the student because of physical health or mental health. For example, in mental health, many people are suffering from mental retardation or any other chronic illnesses or many other severe debilitating disorders, like you can take schizophrenia, severe depression or ADHD. Even conduct disorders. You can take any physical health conditions, for example, chronic debilitating disorders, severe fevers or hypothyroidism. Chronic disorders may disturb his performance in his examinations. Our last hour preparation also one of the causes for poor achievement in examination. So fear of rejection by others, fear of rejection by relatives and friends, or fear of being ridiculed by parents, siblings, elders, or school teachers, or the others. So there are so many factors which inducing stress among children or in sometimes, many times, lead to pressure not only in children, even in parents also. There are few essential elements which are most important for any student or any candidate to want to achieve their life expectations or goals. There must be interest, a real interest, and second one is dedication and commitment. Third is there must be hardworking nature. Simply interesting is not enough, and commitment and dedication, but proper plan with hard working. These are three elements are essential for anybody to want to become what they want. So these are very, very important. Please remember. So you're talking about the stress. How can we decrease? How can we reduce the stress? How can we deal with this kind of stress? Please remember, there are some tips which definitely decrease or tackle with your examination stress. Please remember, there must be proper action plan. It is very essential for anybody. So there must be action plan, that is timetable. Timetable is like oxygen to leave a person on earth. Without oxygen, living is difficult. No way, you cannot achieve anything. So there must be proper plan. For example, what is day today? How many days are left over? You count them according to days. You plan your schedule, your timetable. According to that, you can read well, write well, and prepare well. Plan for 24 hours for a day. At least you study 12 to 14 hours for a day. Go for sleep minimum 7 to 8 hours and take meals for 1 hour and recreation 1 to 2 hours, remaining other freshening and etc. The second is schedule your subjects. Schedule your subject is one of the important cause for schedule your subjects according to your wish, according to your capabilities. Please remember, schedule your subject. Please start with hard or difficult subject which is more tough to you. According to that, you plan it. Start with difficult subjects, and every subject which is important, which is tough to you, that first you prepare to that only. Next is take disciplined action. You have took a proper plan, you prepare a proper plan, you schedule your subject according to timetable. So, but there must be execution or disciplined action. Acting on your action plan or any deviation, you are not following properly. If you are not so, you are wasting your time. You are wasting your time on unnecessary thing. You are not reading, writing and preparing well. Definitely, you are not going to success. You are going to harm to you and others, your life. Coming to the, there are some tips which are definitely improving the concentration of a person before, even during the examinations. Please sit the same place and the same time for studying, so your mind is tuned to that environment. So please put off all the distractions for mobile or tab, TV, computers, any program which are going to disturb you, please put off or switch off, keep away them at the time of examination or during or before examination. Please remember, tell your family members or elders about your timetable. With this time I am studying, please don't disturb me, otherwise they may disturb you. So because of this, they won't disturb at any cost. Please postpone any calls, any programs, whichever close friends or relatives, please switch off your phone and don't go away. The greatest failure in your life is failing to concentration. There are other few exercises definitely which are going to help your concentration. Take deep breathing relaxation technique. Please close your right nostril or whichever you like, or inhale, then we exhale by closing opposite nostril. You repeat for 1 to 2 minutes. Definitely will relax your body, mind, and your relaxed mind and body will encourage, will improve your performance or increase your memory by in turn, which increase your concentration. And second is palming. Rubbing your palms and cover up your eyes definitely will help a minimum or lot. Stretching your body and listening to music and soft music or lovable music, whichever is you like, you fond of it, you more interested. Please, while revising your subjects, fast reading sometime definitely will going to help you. It definitely will improve your concentration at any cost. Making a vision board for formulas, charts and graphics, visualization memory is very easy to grasp and very easy to remember. So visual boards are very, very essential in the part of improving concentration and visualizing your success. So these exercises, these tips definitely will improve in concentration memory of you. Next, coming to the So please be away from rebuttal people. There are so many people, their mind filled with negative thoughts. Always talk about the negativism. Always talk about discussing and describing or hurting you. Always criticize of your studies and negatively talk. So please away from them. The negative talk definitely will impact your mind and brain. You may go into negativism. So mind, your mind also filled with negative thoughts. Please talk to them and go tell them to not to come during the examination or during preparation of your examination or preparation of your studies. So they don't want to come. So if they come, please tell them, ignore them also. Coming to the take right amount of rest. That is very essential. Take right amount of rest. Right amount of sleep are patient's essential component during the examination period. Please remember, you are studying continuously. It is disturbing your mind. It disturbs your body. So continuous studying, disturbing your body and mind, it leads to restlessness. Please remember, for every 1-2 hours, you may take small breaks, 5 to 10 minutes. Just simply you go out and talk to someone who loves you, who interested in you, and relax. You may do a little bit some exercises or listening music, do other exercises and come to your hall and start again your studies. Definitely will relax your body and relax your mind. Please remember about the sleep pattern. The correct amount of sleep, a correct pattern of sleep, enhance your memory. Disturbance or skipping sleeping patterns will disturb you. If you go to sleep more than 7 to 8 hours or less than 4 to 5 hours, it will impair your routine performance or next day performance, your education, your memory, your attention and concentration. So proper sleeping pattern is always important. Otherwise, or night owls, a disturbance in sleep patterns lead to lethargy, memory disturbances, or leads to dullness next day. Please focus on nutritional foods and healthy eating habits. You know, you take nutritious food, it is very important. You should take cereals, which are very, very important. You should take in your food, you should contain milk and milk products, leaf vegetables and fruits and vegetables, especially dry foods which are very, very important. Along with balanced food, you should take some vitamin supplementation which are helping to a lot. Moreover, please remember, balanced diet is very important. Every day you have to take breakfast within the time, a stipulated time. Don't skip the breakfast. Always remember, many people are fond of junk foods. Please remember, junk foods have no energy. Junk foods have no carbohydrates, not more than carbohydrates, fats, or energetic value. If you take junk foods, no use of it, because continuous eating of junk foods, it will lead to lethargy or low level of motivation, low level of energy. Please remember, do some exercises. Many people comment about what is the benefit of exercises during the examination, what is the link between exercises and memory or studying the courses. I am talking about this. Please remember, do some exercises will increase a blood flow to the brain, which in turn will increase the some hormones which are more important in reducing the stress level of a person, which are norepinephrine or endorphin. These two hormones in the brain will reduce your strain. So these neurochemicals or neurotransmitters are very important, but they will come out by regular doing exercise only. So body exercise definitely will relax your body and mind. Please remember, have a positive attitude. You think, feel good about yourself. You see good about yourself. You feel good about yourself. But think and feel good about yourself. You think about your successful man on earth. You think positively. You think never negatively about others. It is not so, it is never late to start about positive thinking. Please remember, stop comparing with others. Stop comparing with others. If you compare with others, it will disturb you. We never compare with others. It is one of the baddest signs for anybody. Think positively. Please have a positive attitude. Definitely it will help you a lot in the future. Affirm positive of talk or affirm positive self-talk. This is, I can achieve what I want. I can get what I want. I will success everything if I read well. Everything is possible on earth. I am the champion. I am not lesser than anybody. I am not least to anybody. Please, I am the best. Trust in yourself. Believe in yourself. Love yourself. Accept the challenge. Definitely you will success. Coming to the be confident. Many people don't have proper confidence. Please remember, self-confidence is very, very important. If you have the self-confidence, you will achieve anything on earth. Self-confidence is very, very crucial for a growing children or those who are in adolescence or during the examination. Confidence will impact your performance, your career, everything, but never compare with others. Failure is not a failure. Failure is not getting up again after failing. Failure is not getting after failing. Please remember, don't think that the other people are commenting about you, the other people are talking negatively about you. Remember, life is also important. Education is also important. Education is part and parcel of the life. Education, passing examination, not at all the life. Life is different. It is simple 20-30% of your life only. Never think of bad about your examination. So with this examination, with this only examination, it is not end of your education, it is not end of your entire life. So please remember, be confident, you will achieve what you want. If you have or if you have any problem or something in your studying during that period, please remember. Please speak to your parents if they are well educated. If you have any doubt, you can contact your tuition master, your contact with your school teachers, your contact with, or you can speak to your elders, sisters, brothers and siblings, those who completed same degree in their lives. Please stay motivated. That is, always try to connect with your classmates. Relax with them, talk with them, discuss what you have learned. Please remember, if you got good marks, reward yourself and can get achieved. Be bold and win success ever. Please make a comment today. Take ownership and you are a responsibility of your life. Please remember, you are the creator of your own destiny. You are responsible for yourself, responsible for your study, responsible for examination, responsible for your career, responsible for life. So take a commitment today only, then you will success. Please do your best. Please forget the rest. If you have the confidence, be bold, you will success. You will always success. Confidence, positive attitude, commitment, dedication and proper plan, which are really helpful a person who want goal, who want achieve their goal, who want to become a doctor, engineer, anyone they want. Really, if you have the good confidence, everything, you will success. Please remember one or two things. Many people used to come, hundreds of people used to ask me, sir, I am forgetting what I was learning during my inter or 10th class. Please remember. That means you are not having proper plan, you are not following your action plan or proper plan, your mind filled with negative thoughts, you are emotionally disturbed, you are not regularly following action plan, not studying well, you are always enjoying. Because of you are not learning, you are not getting concentration, not learning what you want. So these are important. So always remember, confidence is essential. Today or tomorrow going to face the examination. So if suppose tomorrow is the examination. So today what we have to do? If tomorrow is examination, how you have to behave? Please remember, before examination, don't look for new notes or don't look for new chapters, don't look for new books. Don't try to learn anything new to you. Focus on already prepared subjects and prepared chapters only. Talk with your family members. if you have any small or bigger stress with you. Try to have a light dinner. Don't forget, light dinner is essential during examination night or examination day before. Go to bed early, as early possible, but don't cramp or don't bihat all the night. So night owls are very dangerous to you. Please remember. Next day, today is the examination. How to prepare, how to go with them, how to be confident about your examination. Please don't forget your breakfast. If you forget your breakfast, definitely you will not achieve, you will disturbance in the memory or attention concentration because of low level of glucose. Second, check out all the things which are essential for today's examination, pen, pencil, or any hall ticket, etc. Leave for examination or well in advance. Please go to examination at least 1-2 hours before. Please avoid the panic people. Some people at the examination are putting the books in the hands. They want to read. They loudly talk about the examination, which this bit is coming, that bit is very important. Don't panic. Don't listen to them. Don't keep away them also. Please, if you get any tension, you take some breath, deep breath relaxation techniques. Inhale and exhale, definitely which is going to relax your mind and body. Importantly, you must go to toilets before entering to the examination hall. Next, don't skip your breakfast. Be confident. Before entering to the examination hall, many students complain that, sir, I did not prepare well, I did not cover what I have to cover, so I am going to fail. So negative comments, negative thoughts, please ignore. Don't get negative thoughts a day of examination or before going to examination hall. Don't be panic. Be confident. You are going to success on earth. You are the creator of your own destiny. You are the great man. You are achieving. You are successing. All the best. Good luck. Jai Hind.